Isang mapagpalang araw po sa ating lahat. So, sa ngayon po, dito po ulit tayo sa Novena Church para magsasimba po tayo. Mahalo po sa inyo sa araw nito, ngayong araw po ng Martes, November 24, 2020. So, sa ngayon po, nais ko pong bahagi ang live na misa na aking i-upload po sa ngayon. Samahan po ako upang magdasal at manalangin po sa araw na ito. Maraming salamat po. God bless po sa ating lahat.
Brothers and sisters in Christ, peace Christ for the Angelus. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The angel of the Lord declared to Mary, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Behold, the handmaid of the Lord. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. And the Word was made flesh. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Pray for us, most holy Mother of God. Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech you, Lord, your grace into our hearts, that we to whom the incarnation of Christ your Son was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Mass will commence shortly. Today we celebrate the memorial of Saint Andrew Dung-Lac and companions, martyrs, entrance and return. May we never boast except in the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ. For the word of the cross is the power of God to us who have been saved.
A warm welcome to all of you, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ. We begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Today we commemorate the memorial of Saint Andrew Dung-Lac and companions. He's one of the 117 martyrs of Vietnam in the year of 1820, between 1820 to 1860. Through their faith, witness of their faith, may we also feel inspired and encouraged to persevere in our faith in the midst of challenges in our life. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, you came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father, to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, source and origin of all fatherhood, who kept the martyr Saint Andrew Dung-Lac and his companions faithful to the cross of your Son, even to the shedding of their blood, grant through their intercession that spreading your love among our brothers and sisters, we may be your children both in name and in truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the Apocalypse. In my vision, I, John, saw a white cloud, and sitting on it, one like the Son of Man, with a gold crown on his head and a sharp sickle in his hand. Then another angel came out of the sanctuary and shouted aloud to the one sitting on the cloud, "Put your sickle in and reap. Harvest time has come, and the harvest of the earth is ripe." Then the one sitting on the cloud set his sickle to work on the earth, and the earth's harvest was reaped. Another angel, who also carried a sharp sickle, came out of the temple in heaven. And the angel in charge of the fire left the altar and shouted aloud to the one with the sharp sickle, "Put your sickle in and cut all the bunches off the vine of the earth. All its grapes are ripe." So the angel set his sickle to work on the earth and harvested the whole vintage of the earth, and put it into a huge winepress, the winepress of God's anger. The word of the Lord. The response is, the Lord comes to rule the earth. The Lord comes to rule the earth. Proclaim to the nations, God is King. The world He made firm in its place. He will judge the peoples in fairness. Let the heavens rejoice and earth be glad. Let the sea and all within it thunder praise. The Lord comes to rule the earth. Let the land and all it bears rejoice. All the trees of the wood shout for joy. At the presence of the Lord, for He comes. He comes to rule the earth. With justice, He will rule the earth. He will judge the peoples with His truth. The Lord comes to rule the earth. Please rise for the gospel declaration. Alleluia, alleluia. Stand erect, hold your heads high, because your liberation is near at hand. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. When some were talking about the temple, remarking how it was adorned with fine stonework and votive offerings, Jesus said, "All these things you are staring at now, the time will come when not a single stone will be left on another. Everything will be destroyed." And they put to him this question, "Master," they said, "when will this happen then? And what sign will there be that this is about to take place?" "Take care not to be deceived," He said, "because many will come using my name and saying, 'I am He,' and the time is near at hand. Refuse to join them. And when you hear of wars and revolutions, do not be frightened. For this is something that must happen, but the end is not so soon." Then He said to them, "Nation will fight against nation, and kingdom against kingdom. There will be great earthquakes and plagues and famines here and there. There will be fearful sights and great signs from heaven." The Gospel. For St. Andrew Yumla and his companions, they knew what their lives were meant to be the moment they embraced Christ as their Lord and Master. From the account of their stories of martyrdom, we could just imagine the amount of tortures that they had to go through when they defended their faith. As I mentioned earlier, St. Andrew Dung-Lac is one of the 117 martyrs in Vietnam who lost their lives in various persecutions from 1740 to 1883. It was such a moving and empowering story for all of us. If you remember, one of the church fathers said, Tertullian, by the name of Tertullian, he coined this term, "The blood of the martyrs is the seed of the church." They definitely went through an unspeakable pain and suffering, but never gave up their faith. Why? because they themselves became the temple of God's Spirit, who can never be destroyed. Their flesh, their human flesh, might be destroyed, but not with their spirit. Yes, my dear friends in Christ, when we have Christ in us, which we believe through our faith, at times we might stumble. We might experience many kinds of martyrdom in this modern time, our sacrifices, maybe not too dramatic as those martyrs before. But God will never allow our spirit to be shattered or die. Yes, this is a great assurance for all of us when we believe Jesus as our Lord, Master of our life. In fact, people can probably belittle our faith. The world might see that our faith as unreasonable, but we know deep in our hearts that our faith is much more deeper than all these pains and sorrows. Look at our Lord. He died and rose again. And the martyrs, just like St. Andrew and his companions, saw this through the eyes of their faith. He is the true temple. Jesus himself has set a good example that he is the true temple of God's Spirit. He is the invisible presence of God the Father that can never be destroyed. Those who believe in him will continue to live in his Spirit eternally. When Jesus spoke about the temple with its fine stonework and votive offerings, which we have heard in the Gospel today, when he said this, the time will come when not a single stone will be left on another. He is inviting us to look beyond this physical temple. The temple that man built can never be destroyed. But the temple that God built in our life will endure forever. So my dear friends in Christ, when we know we are the temple of God's Spirit, that no human coming, no man can destroy, hopefully it will be a great source of consolation, a great source of strength, especially when we live in this world filled with so many challenges. May God give all of you today the strength, the courage, and the hope when you walk in your own martyrdom in Christ. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for to your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty
Father.
Receive, O Holy Father, the offerings we bring, as we venerate the passion of the holy martyrs, so that amid the trials of this life, we may always be found faithful, and may offer ourselves to you as an acceptable sacrifice, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
Lift up your Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you are glorified when your saints are praised. Their very sufferings are but wonders of your might. In your mercy, you give ardor to their faith. To their endurance, you grant firm resolve. And in their struggle, the victory is yours. Through Christ our Lord. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration, and we, with all the host of angels, cry out, and without end, we acclaim, Holy, Holy, Holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the Father of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for me, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Thank you. mystery of faith. We proclaim
and profess the resurrection until he comes.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. How may we pray that by thinking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and William, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of your resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your faith. Have mercy on the soul, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, the spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced with eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
And the Savior's command and call by divine teaching, to hear and say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant a peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Peace be with you. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
union and heaven. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Holy Communion is distributed row by row, starting from the back row. Please form two lines in the middle aisle and maintain a safe distance of 1 meter on the side and in front of you. Please follow the stickers on the floor as a guide. As you approach the front of the queue, there is a sanitizer. Please sanitize your hands before receiving communion on the hand. Do not remove your mask when receiving communion. Take a few steps to your right or left accordingly before pulling down your mask and consuming the host. Please also ensure that you put your mask back on immediately after receiving communion. Thank you for your cooperation.
Let us pray. Redeemed by the one bread, as we commemorate the holy martyrs, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that abiding as one in your love, we may merit by endurance an eternal prize, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may the Almighty God bless all of you, Father, Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Have a blessed day.
Diyan po nagtatapos ang ating misa po sa araw po ng Martyrs, November 24. Maraming salamat po at sinamahan niyo po ulit ako para patuloy po tayo magpasalamat sa mga biyaya na ating natatanggap. So, please continue po sa our supporting my YouTube channel. You can search EDS Mix Vlogs po at update po kayo sa future news po. Salamat po at hanggang sa muli, pag-upload po ulit at susuportan sa channel. So, maraming salamat at ligayang araw.